The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus took with him Peter and John and James and went up the mountain to pray. As he prayed, the aspect of his face was changed, and his clothing became brilliant as lightning. Suddenly there were two men there talking to him. They were Moses and Elijah, appearing in glory. And they were speaking of his passing, which he was to accomplish in Jerusalem. Peter and his companions were heavy with sleep, but they kept awake and saw his glory, and the two men standing with him. As these were leaving him, Peter said to Jesus, "Master, it is wonderful for us to be here. So let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He did not know what he was saying. As he spoke, the cloud came and covered them with shadow. And when they went into the cloud, the disciples were afraid. And a voice came from the cloud saying, "This is my son, the chosen one. Listen to him." And after the voice had spoken, Jesus was found alone. The disciples kept silence, and at that time told no one what they had seen. The Gospel of the Lord.
The Gospel that we've just heard is unique, or at least what it describes, the Transfiguration. And it is read every year on the second Sunday of Advent. And we also celebrate the Feast of the Transfiguration on the 6th of August. It is unique in that it was the only time that the disciples saw, if you like, the divinity of Jesus. He was outwardly transfigured. His appearance changed. To most, he was simply the carpenter's son, the prophet from Nazareth. And it wasn't something seen by all the disciples. Only three were chosen to see Jesus in glory: Peter, James, and John. The purpose of this revelation, this apparition, was to strengthen the disciples for what was about to take place. Jesus was going to be tortured and crucified, and he was to die in agony on the cross. Peter, as we know, who was present, was actually to betray Jesus three times. James simply fled at the Passion from the Garden of Gethsemane. It was only John who was to stay at Jesus' side at the cross, together with his mother Mary. Even though we have not seen the divinity of Christ, the message to us is to listen to him. The Father's voice was heard saying those very words. As well as listening to Jesus, we also have to put his words, his teaching, into practice. But the mistake, perhaps, is that of Peter's, that we are quite happy to know Jesus in his glory, but in some ways we are ashamed of Jesus as the man of sorrows, the one who was disfigured, buffeted, crowned with thorns, who died like a criminal hanging from a cross. Pope Benedict, in his book Jesus of Nazareth, tells us Jesus' divinity belongs with the cross. Only when we put the two together do we recognize Jesus correctly. Jesus appears in glory, and on either side appear Moses, representing the law, and Elijah, the prophets. Jesus tells us that he did not come to abolish either the law or the prophets, but he was the fulfillment, and that was shown in the Transfiguration. But most important of all, of course, was Jesus' law of love. He died for us, he suffered for us, because he loves us so much. So as we continue our Lenten journey, let us listen to Jesus. Let us not close our hearts to him, but let us be proud Christians, proud of Jesus' message of love and salvation, and let us share it with others.